Hello everyone, my name is Jared Kim. I'm a human biology major undergraduate at UC San Diego and part of the BioClock Studio Winter 2016. Today, I'll be talking about the two-process model of sleep regulation. While scientists are still figuring out the full function of sleep, we do know that a lack of sleep influences people's daily lives negatively and leads to some serious consequences, like a loss in attention span, memory issues, and overall impaired brain activity, as well as an increased risk of obesity. Sleep, in its simplest form, is controlled by two processes, the circadian clock, or process C, and the sleep homeostasis, or process S. One component, the circadian clock, is an internal daily biological clock present in humans and many other organisms. The word circadian comes from the Latin, meaning about a day. Thus, our circadian rhythms are 24-hour rhythms. In humans, the circadian clock controls physiological processes that rise and fall every 24 hours, with a model example of this being oscillations in body temperature. As you can see, the body temperature peaks around 5 to 6 p.m. and is lowest around 5 to 6 a.m. This cycle then repeats every 24 hours. Process C is controlled by the same circadian clock that regulates body temperature. This graph plots the circadian alerting signal, which controls how alert the person feels, with its peak around 6 to 8 p.m. Conversely, the person would feel least alert around 4 to 6 a.m. This rhythm repeats itself from one day to the next and is distinct from a sense of sleepiness that is related to how long a person has been awake. Process C explains why you can get a second wind even though you are sleep deprived. That brings us to the second process involved in sleep-wake cycles called sleep homeostasis, also known as process S. Unlike the circadian clock, which reinitiates a cycle on its own every 24 hours just like an oscillator, process S is more like an hourglass that requires an event to restart it. A person's sleep pressure will continuously build up as long as the person is awake. Once the person falls asleep, the sleep pressure dissipates, just like turning that hourglass over and letting the sand flow in the other direction. As you can see in this graph, the person wakes up at 9 a.m. At this time, the sleep pressure is very low because the person slept long enough to deplete all the sleep pressure from the night before and just woke up. But the longer they stay awake, the higher the sleep drive builds until the person eventually falls asleep, in this case, around midnight. Of course, remember that sleep drive is working against the circadian alerting signal, which is why even as we begin to get sleepy in the evening from the buildup of sleep pressure, we can still stay awake. With these two processes, we see how a normal sleep-wake cycle is formed, assuming the person sleeps around 12 a.m. to 9 a.m. The circadian clock provides a daily cycle of alerting signal, which encourages wakefulness during the day and sleepiness during the night. Working against the circadian alerting signal is the homeostatic sleep pressure, which builds up while the individual is awake and is alleviated when the person sleeps, as shown here in the blue arrows. The sleep pressure antagonizes the circadian alerting signals, and the balance of circadian alerting signals and homeostatic sleep pressure creates a normal waveform of wake propensity. As you can see, this person follows a regular sleep pattern with their wake and sleep episodes during the same interval of each 24-hour period. This person follows a normal pattern, sleeping in the first part of the night because homeostatic sleep pressure is high and staying asleep in the second part of the night due to a low circadian alerting signal. Conversely, during the day, the person is awake in the morning because there is low homeostatic sleep pressure and staying awake later in the day even though sleep pressure has built up because the circadian alerting signal is also high. So now that we know how a normal sleep-wake cycle is formed, what happens when we put stress on our body and don't sleep for a night? Whether it's pulling an all-nighter, staying awake for the night shift, or binge-watching your favorite TV show, not sleeping will have adverse effects on your normal sleep-wake cycle. As you can see here, this individual decided to skip sleep on the second night. Sleep homeostasis continues to build up sleep pressure due to the lack of sleep, continuing until the third night, when the individual finally sleeps. The circadian clock continues to cycle normally and provides a consistent alerting signal interval. With this huge rise in sleep pressure, the person's alertness level will fall greatly during the time where the alerting signal is very low. This leads to a high risk of falling asleep. In addition to this risk, the person accrues a sleep debt, and just like a financial debt, this has to be paid back. The problem is that just sleeping your normal amount the next night is not enough for you to make up for the lost night. For several nights, you have to sleep longer than your normal amount to make up your sleep debt. That's it for this video on the two-process model of sleep regulation. For more information on circadian biology, please visit the UC San Diego BioClock Studio by clicking the link.